It's hard to explain how I feel. It's it's a bit of a dream. I'm sure it's going to take a while for this to set in, and we'll go and we'll have a good party tonight and think about it tomorrow.
When did you feel like
you're going to win? I suppose when I hold the seminar on the 11th hole and get on in the fight for the lead, but it sort of felt like, only my day when stuff like that happens. It's you get that feeling, and thankfully it is. Yeah, I played. I felt very comfortable all week. I've done well here in the past, and I felt like this is a tournament that I could do well in. And I'm very comfortable coming here. I played lovely all week, and very thankful to be standing here as the winner.
How will you celebrate this victory?
I think we'll be staying in Villamora tonight, and then home tomorrow, and back in my hometown tomorrow for homecoming, I suppose.
Finish. Do you enjoy playing in Portugal?
Yeah, I love playing in Portugal. I won here as an amateur as well, so it's a happy hunting ground for me. So yeah.
Thanks. And enjoy.
Good crowd for the Portugal Masters. And with that, I think you do deserve a round of applause.
Done such a great job this week to look after our huge crowd. So thank you to the volunteers.
Gostaríamos de agradecer a vocês, os espectadores, acima de 40 mil espectadores nestes últimos 5 dias, portanto, recorde para o Portugal Masters. E também gostaríamos de agradecer ao Golf for Grace, porque sem eles, os voluntários que têm ajudado em tudo neste campeonato. Portanto, Sandra Slater e Graham Wallace foram quem tomou conta desse Golf for Grace, 370 voluntários.
There's something about the Portuguese Masters that is very special to the European Tour. We just love coming to this country, we love coming here. There's a particular Irish flavour. I think if we watch today, I think to have the Irish Open Champions of 2009-2010,
so close. Now he's won one of our best tournaments as a professional.
Last year was special. Tom Lewis, I think, in his third tournament as a pro, won here in Portugal to go on to great things. I think this speaks volumes for Shane's future. Ross Fisher is a very tough man to beat into second place, and this is a win he's going to cherish. And it's because of everybody at this table that this tournament is so, this green, that this tournament is so great. Minister, we thank you for your belief in this tournament and what it does for Portugal. I can't tell you how many people here in the audience have arrived, have asked me, are we coming back? What are the dates? Can they book their vacations for next year? I've been watching this tournament on Sky Television in the United Kingdom. And I'll tell you, the pictures are stunning. Not
huge, some of the greatest activities ever. It has people that has got pride and ability.
In the world for several times. The last of this time was about 2 weeks ago. I think today proves that this is true. So I hope I'll be seeing you again. You are very welcome to Portugal. Thank you very much.
I'll be seeing you again.
Thank you very much. Just before we move to the prizes, I just want to comment on the charity initiative that took place this week. And we were raising funds for two very worthy children's charities, Refugio from Faro, an APPA CDM with their donations for the draw sheet and also for the programme and for the long putt challenge. All of those donations have been matched by the Tour Players Foundation, which is the charitable arm of the European Tour. And I'm very pleased to say that a total of over 15,000 euro was raised for the charities this week. So thank you so much. Manuel. And finally, to the main event, we'll ask the Secretary of State, Cecilia Morelos, to come forward to present the Portugal Masters Trophy to our winner.
Yes, see.
Thank you. First of all, I cannot believe I'm standing here. Portuguese Masters champion for 2012. It's a bit surreal, to be honest, but I'm sure after a couple of Guinness tonight, I'll be all right. I'd like to thank Turismo de Portugal, Oceanico and the Tivoli Hotels for their sponsorship of the tournament. It's, you know, without these, we obviously wouldn't be here this week, and we're very grateful to have a tournament and, you know, such a wonderful golf course and such a wonderful place. So thanks to those. To all the staff at the golf course, no, the green staff, the chefs over there, he looked after us very well this week. The everyone that had anything to do with the golf course this week, it was in magnificent condition. Is Golf for Greys, who organised the volunteers and the marshals.
Without you today, anyway, all the Irish out there today, you know, I probably wouldn't be standing here. You're the 15th club in the bag. So, thanks to you. To my coach, Neil Manship, he's not here this week, but Neil, I've been with Neil for about 7 years now, and he's a huge inspiration to me, and you know, we get on great, and I definitely would not be standing here without him, and you know, this is for him. To my caddy Dermot, we've been together for about 3 years now, just over 3 years, and it's going as good as ever, so thank Dermot. This one, it's been a long time coming, but we haven't. To my family, my mom and dad, you know, what can I say? Obviously, you know, words can't describe how happy I am and how happy they are right now. And the fact that this is only the second tournament my mom's come to this year, and I've managed to win it. So she used to always think that she was my bad omen, but I think it's the other way around now. So thanks. Cheers. My management company, Horizon Sports, you know, thanks for all your help over the last, since I turned pro, you're great, and you know, I'm sure we have a long relationship ahead of us in the future as well. And you know, I've nothing more to say, only, you know, it's time to party.
Thank you, Shane. That concludes the prize giving for the 2012 Portugal Masters. Just remains for me to thank you one more time for your magnificent support and to say we look forward to seeing you again next year. Thank you.
Portanto, terminamos aqui a distribuição de prémios. Agradecer a todos vós por terem vindo e esperamos vê-los todos aqui esta mesma semana para o ano. Nosso muito obrigado.
God help Paddy Power!
Just hit this beautiful little 7-iron, chipped it, and just took off straight at the flag, stayed there, and the crowd told the rest of the story.
Yeah, you mentioned the crowd there. I mean, the support you had, obviously, when you won in Beltrade Special. Well, I guess this was a pretty close second.
Yeah, it was amazing, the crowd out there today. I knew there was a few guys from home down, and a few of my parents' friends and stuff, but the Irish support down here was brilliant this week, and you know, I owe them a lot, I suppose, and you know, it was great.
Climbing to the top 30 of the race of Dubai, you can book your trip to Dubai at the end of the season.
Yeah,
confidence go there as well.
Yeah, that was the plan coming into this week. I was going to, you know, I think a top five, but it almost everything would secure me in, so just going a little bit step further, and you know, happy enough.
Take some questions from the floor. You got a microphone, we can use that. So everyone can hear on the phone.
Shane, it was interesting that in several of the TV interviews you said, you know, I can get rid of this sort of being known as the fellow. He's proud of that achievement.
Yeah.
But it was something you wanted to surpass, yes?
Yeah, definitely, Graham. Was, obviously, what I done in Baltrea was special, and it'll never be forgotten, but it's almost like this is another monkey off my back now. It's now to win on tour and to be a two-time winner on tour. I'm only 25, so hopefully I've got a long career ahead of me, and I can get plenty more.
One thing also, which picking up from the TV interviews, you said you were going out to think about it, blah blah blah. Are you still going to America?
I don't know. I'll have to see. First of all, where my world ranking is after today, and what tournaments this will get me in for the rest of the year. I'll sit down with Connor during the week, and we'll talk about it. I'm supposed to head off to America on Thursday. I probably still will, and we'll see from there.
You're going to about the top 70, so they're projecting.
Mm-hmm.
Would that then get you into stage 2 without stage 1?
It does, doesn't it? It gets me straight through to stage 2. I think so, yeah. So that'd be perfect. But yeah.
How would you compare your golf today and win it to when you won at Baltrea in America? The actual playing in the game. Competing.
Yeah, I don't. To be honest, I'm 4 years older now, or 3 years older than when I won in Baltrea. But I think my golf game is 100 times better than it was back then. I haven't fulfilled my potential yet. And this is only a step to fulfilling my potential, and where I can really go in the world of golf. And if you ask me what my game was like in Baltrea was like today, it's totally different. I won in Baltrea. Everything went right for me, and everything went right for me today, but my golf is a lot better, and I'm more comfortable, and I feel like I belong on the tour.
Just wondering if you, besides sharing your Fox Zero yesterday with Jerry Fagan, if you had any special connection with Portugal, if you played here as an amateur, if you know any of the Portuguese players like Lim or Santos?
I've won a tournament down in Valdelobo before as an amateur. I used to come over for a couple of winters over to Amandira to practice. So I've been down here quite a bit. I've spent a bit of time down here over the last few years, and I love coming down here. This golf course really suits me, and I love it here. Yeah.
Did you know that we had so many Irish residents here? A lot of people from Ireland.
Yeah.
Houses here in
Galway. I knew that today. Yeah, found that out today. It was. There's obviously a lot of Irish down here, yeah, and for us the weather's great, as if compared to back home, so I can understand why.
I didn't understand part of your speech back there, but did you say that the course was the toughest you?
Yeah, the toughest I've ever seen it, because it's so firm. Whatever they did to make it, obviously the weather has been good, but the course was very firm and it was quite tough, and it was really enjoyable. It was a tough test to golf, so it was great, yeah.
Thank you.